Hello everyone, this is Ashijan. In this video, we will do another relaxation on payroll. So let's start with this example. Now the question is, a renowned private company pays to its employees the components of salary on the basis of basic pay. The components of salary are computed according to the following terms of contract of services. First point is, dearness allowance is paid at 22% of basic pay rounded to nearest 10. So as we did in the last video, for this we will apply round off function. Now the next point is, TA is paid on the basis of category. For category A, TA is to be paid at rupees 3000, for B 5000, and for C 8000. Now for HRA also, the HRA is payable as per the category. For A 20%, for B 30%, for C 40%. However, the amount of HRA can't exceed rupees 11,000 in any case. So which means, for this we will use min function. Now go to next point. Children education allowance is rupees 500 per month per child up to 2 children. What does that mean? That means if the employee have children up to 2 2 children, then they will get rupees 500 per month. Otherwise they will get nil. Okay, now next point is, the contribution of PF will be 10% of basic plus DA and then rounded up to nearest 10. Then the income tax would be 15% on gross minus PF and then rounded up to 10. The basic pay is in the pay grade of rupees 10,000. The annual increment was of rupees 1,000 and the highest value of basic pay will be 30,000. Assume category of employee and year of experience on your own and generate number of children between 0 to 5 randomly and fix them before entering them as column. So which means, for the basic pay and for the number of children, we need to use data validation. Okay, so let's start with this in the Excel sheet. Now in this Excel sheet, I have already made a draft, that is basic pay for the month of 2019 we don't know, so we will use here data validation. Number of children, again we don't know, like which employee have how many children. Okay, so again we will use data validation. Now the first column is for name and the second column is for category. So let's give them different category, A, B, C, then again A, B, sorry, B, C. Now for this we need to here is we need to use data validation. So let's make a list. And now the basic pay starting from rupees 10,000 and the annual increment of rupees 1,000. So which means we can write here 11,000. Okay, and then select both the cells and then drop down till rupees 30,000. Okay, now the next column is for number of children. So as per this question, we need to assume that the children that means we need to make a children, we need to make children from 0 to 5. Yes, from 0 to 5. So 0, 1, select both these cells and then drop down till 5. Okay, now come to this cell. I have already applied the data validation. So let's assume 25,000 here and number of children, let's assume 2. Okay, Now let's start with the basic pay. Now let's assume the basic pay is rupees 25,000 for each employee. Okay, so we need to fix up this value. And then drop down to last. Okay, now for the DA. For the DA, the question says DNS allowance is paid at 22% of basic pay rounded to nearest 10. So we need to here use roundup function equal to roundup, then take 22% of basic pay, that is C7. C7. Okay, we don't need to use here formula bracket here. So 22% of C7, and then round it up to 10 decimal place, that is minus 1. Okay, so this will be the DA. Now drop down this. Okay, now the TA and HRA is payable as per the category wise. So we need to use here VLOOKUP function. So for this we need to make here category. So category A, B, C. Okay. Then here we need TA and HRA. Okay. First we will use TA and then HRA. Okay, now for the calculation of TA, the TA is paid as per category wise for A 3000, B 5000 and C 8000. So for, sorry, we need to hear C. Now for A 3000, for B 5000, for C 8000. Okay, so here we will use VLOOKUP function equal to VLOOKUP, right open, then press FX. Lookup value will be this category, table area would be this all. Okay. Now which column for the TA? Second column. So we'll write here 2. Okay, now fix up this. We need to fix up only B. Okay, and but we need to fix up the all table array, because we need to apply this table array for all employees. Okay, 3000. Now let's drop down this. Now here we can say the TA is value, or all the values are allocated as per the category. Now come to HRA. Now for the calculation of HRA, the question says that the HRA is payable as per category wise 22%. 20% of 20% of what? 20% of basic pay. Okay. But the maximum amount of HRA would be rupees 11,000. So which means we need to use min function. Okay, so for the calculation, this equal to min 20% of 20% of basic plus DA, basic plus DA, and the maximum amount should be rupees 11,000. Okay, bracket close and then press enter. So the amount will be rupees 6,100. Same for this, equal to min 30% of 30% of basic plus DA, and the maximum amount should be rupees 11,000. Now for C category, equal to main 40% of basic plus DA, basic plus DA, and the amount of HRA can't exceed rupees 11,000. Okay, now here you can see the amount comes to rupees 11,000 maximum amount. Okay, now for this column we will use VLOOKUP, bracket open, fx, lookup value is for this category, table array, this whole table, and the column for HRA would be 3. Okay, now we need to fix up this B and then fix up this whole table array for each employee. Now press OK and then drop down to last. Okay, now as you can see very well, the value for TA and HRA are allocated as per category wise. Okay, now the next column is for children education allowance. Now let's read again. The children education allowance is rupees 500 per month per child up to two children. Okay, so which means we need to apply formula here. Equal to, if this cell is equal to or less than 2, then the value should be 500, otherwise it would be 0. Then bracket close and then press 1. Yes. And then for this, now let's drop down. First we need to fix up here B3 by dollar sign and then drop down to last. Okay, now here you can see if I change the number of children to 3, then the amount of CA will be 0. Up to 0, 500, 4, 1, again 500, 2, again 500, 4, 0. Okay, so now we can see that key up to 2 children, the amount of full children education amount would be rupees 500. Okay, now the next column is for gross, that is summation of all basic and all the allowances. Okay, and then drop down this. Now for the calculation PF, question saying the contribution of PF would be 10% basic plus DA and then rounded up to nearest 10. Okay, so equal to round up, then take 10% of basic plus DA, basic plus DA, and round it up to nearest 10. Okay, so this will be the contribution of PF. Okay, now for the income tax, the question says income tax would be 10 15% of gross minus PF, and then round it to nearest 10. Income tax would be rounded up, and then take 10% of 15% of 15% of gross minus PF. Now the self of PF would be I7, okay, and then round it up to 10, nearest 10, okay, press enter and then drop down this. The total deduction will be PF plus IT, sorry, equal to this plus this. Press enter. So this will be the total deduction, and the net salary would be equal to gross minus total deduction. Okay, so here again we will use here sum function, summation of all this. Sorry, it would be C18. Okay, and then towards the right. Okay, so this is the another session on payroll. I hope you understand very well this concept. For any query, you can comment on this. Please keep like and subscribe my channel. Thank you.